beautiful people, welcome back. I hope everyone is having a beautiful day today. And in today's video, you guys, we are finally sitting down and doing another purchase or pass video. And these are some of my favorite freaking videos to film. I think they are so fun. Because if you're new here and you know you've never been through one of these with me, what I like to do is go through like Trendmood or Ulta, Sephora, like the new section on a bunch of different places. And I like to just go through things that are launching, talk about them, give you my thoughts, my opinions. And sometimes we really love them and we praise them and we're like, oh my God, I'm so excited. And other times, we definitely go through and we roast them a little. And let me just tell you right now, okay, if there was ever a day that you were going to get some raw, unfiltered thoughts and opinions, it would be today, because today I am still channeling my inner Teresa. I just got done filming this full face, testing Teresa is Dad's favorite makeup, which I will link up here if you didn't see it. It should have been, I want to say, Monday's video for you guys. And it was so fun. Like, I love this look. I feel so inspired right now to be my most sassy self. Today is definitely going to be one of those days for me where I'm just like, ooh, like I'm going in and I'm ready for it. So if that sounds like something you're into, if you want to see my purchase or pass, what I plan on picking up or did pick up or all the thoughts and opinions, definitely stay tuned because we're going to get into it in a second. But before we get into the video, as per usual here, I like to pause at the start of my videos and just introduce myself for anybody that might be new. My name is Paige. This is Seeking Alexandria. And I do put up 3 new videos. If you decide you like me, you're like, damn, I stick around with this bitch. I dig her. I put up 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, right around 7:30-ish a.m. my time here in good old Northern Michigan. And then also in addition to that, okay, you may not have heard yet, but I'm trying to hit 10,000 followers over on Instagram. So if you would just take a real quick second to go follow me, I would greatly appreciate it. Everything will be linked in the description box. I promise you, by the way, that this is a follow that will be worth your time because I post a ton of content over there, whether it is like makeup inspo, makeup IGTV, mini makeup tutorials, makeup reels, stuff like that. I also do plus size fashion, artsy type photos. All of that is kind of going on in the feed. I like to keep it very interactive. I post several times a week. And then also in the day-to-day portion of it, I do post a ton in the IG stories, which is just like the 24-hour portion. And that I love to do like unboxings. We hang out in the office. We do little chats. We take polls. And a lot of times the IG story is kind of like the behind the scenes of my life or like what's going on. So you guys will kind of know what's going to the channel first, what I just got in, the stuff, kind of like everything that's going on, even updates on like makeup and stuff that I've been wearing. That sort of stuff will be over there as well. So really, if you're into me here at all, like I said, you'll go follow me over on Instagram because that is just where everything happens, okay? That's where the magic happens. It's behind the scenes and it's just a good old continuation of what I do here. So go do that. Everything will be linked down below. And with that, let's go ahead. I'm gonna grab my phone and we're gonna get started. All right, so first up, we're gonna touch on this one very briefly because I've already talked about these, I think actually over on Instagram, but these are the new Fenty Cream Gloss Bombs. And a couple of you guys here have actually asked me if I was gonna be checking these out. And I just wanted to let you all know, if you don't follow me on Instagram and you're looking for like swatches or anything, I did put them up over there a week or two ago already. I went through, I did pick up all 5 shades. I test them out, that way you guys can see what they look like, so on and so forth. So definitely check out Instagram for more info. But just a heads up, I did pick these up. They are so beautiful. I've been wearing them a ton. And by the time I wear them actually on camera here, I'll definitely have some thoughts. So stay tuned for that. But they are so beautiful. I love these colors so much. All right, so next up we have a launch from Too Faced. And I don't know why, but this one really caught me off guard. This is their new, there's two things. Their new lip balm, Peach Bloom lip balm, and their Peach Bloom lip and cheek tint. And for me with these, as of right now, I haven't committed to picking up any. They did launch back on December 8th, but I haven't committed to these because number one, with a balm, especially in the winter, you guys, I am so painfully picky because for me, my lips, like they have to have a certain type of hydration. And right now I'm like still working on finding the balance. And I really don't think that these are going to be that for me. So if I were to reach for a lip balm like this, it would probably be more of like a light summery kind of balm. So I didn't pick those up. And then I also didn't pick up the lip and cheek tint because I am so weird. Like my skin is when it comes to these kind of products. And I don't know if I'm the only one, but I have an issue with like the texture of certain balms, like cream products. If they are too thin or they're too like emollient or whatever, like they tend to almost seep through my skin and they actually emphasize my redness and they make my foundation like move around and just make the whole complexion thing not work for me. And so until I see a few reviews of these, until I get a better view of the texture like in real life, whether that's like in store or just, you know, watching somebody, whatever, I probably won't pick these up just for that reason, because again, my skin can get kind of funky. And I don't know what it was about this. Maybe it's that it was a part of this whole peach collection, but I just did not expect this. Like it was so out of left field for me that I was just like, what the hell even is this? So I'm not mad at it or anything. I'm not like overly drawn in either. Like I'm kind of like, eh, whatever. Like, you know, next. Okay, so here's another one. Just as I'm like scrolling through, I want to mention, I did a full video on the e.l.f. Camo CC Cream. Like I tested out some new e.l.f. stuff. If you haven't seen it, I will link it up here. But I was just scrolling through on Trend Mood and they're showing that. They're showing their new mascara. And I just wanted to mention, if you didn't see it, I will link it up above. I did do a full video on that. It's actually a really decent, you know, full coverage CC cream. Very interesting, the difference in like the compare and contrast between that and the IT Cosmetics one, if you've never seen or played around with that. I definitely mention it. I bring it up a little in the video. So if you're curious, check that out. All right, so I'm just gonna really like throw myself out there for a second. You guys, this ColourPop collection, I feel like so many people have dogged on this. And I, when I tell you, okay, I almost purchased this entire collection. This is their Big Poppy palette collection. And I freaking love it, okay? I love the color story. It's got like all the neutrals, the oranges, the browns, just like, oh, just like give me all the neutral things. And then when I saw that they paired it not only with the neutral palette, okay, but they also added on, look, I had to like switch hands. They also added on these lippy sticks and brown lippy pencils. Like, ugh, you guys, I am obsessed with I'm obsessed with a nude brown lip. Can you not tell? I feel like this entire collection was so like completing of my soul, and I almost picked it up. Like I was this close. And the only reason that I didn't, like the only thing I, you know, I had a little common sense just kind of come over me like a wave. I don't know how that happened, but I decided in the end not to pick it up just because I do have a lot of palettes that look like this, you know, with the orangey and the nude vibe. So for that reason, number one, I was like, ugh, you don't need it. But also in addition to that, it's really not the time for me where I would be wearing this kind of color story. Like this is much more of a going into fall story for me personally. Like obviously I wear neutrals all the time. I was wearing some today. But this specific palette for me, it was much more of like in that realm. It's got the orange, that kind of fall feel. And so I decided, you know, like I said, in the end, not to grab it, but like, bitch, I thought it was so good. And by the way, just really quick, how about we make Paige feel better in the comments, okay? Am I the only person that I can have 1,000 nude palettes? I love all the nude browns and all the golden, whatever colors, the oranges, whatever. I love them so much. Am I the only one that loves them so damn much? And I have 1,000, but at the same time, every time they launch a new one, like I want that one too. I feel like I need them all. And I don't know what that is. Like, what is that neutral being inside of me that needs all of these things? I don't know, but just let me know down in the comments, okay, if I'm the only one, because I can't be. I can't be the only person that's this obsessed with neutrals. But like this palette, oh my God, so beautiful. I love it so much. Okay, so here's one we can talk about for a second. This is the collab between Hip Dot and My Chemical Romance. And this, I don't know what it was about this collab. I saw it launch over on Ulta, which by the way, it sold out like that. And this collab, I just thought it was so, so fantastic. Like, is the color story, you know, something I would gravitate towards? No, it's not really my vibe. But like, there's something about the nostalgia factor for me that is so real. Very much so, like akin to the, what was it? The Morphe Lisa Frank thing that they had going on there. It's that same kind of vibe. Like ninth grade Paige, My Chemical Romance, like feeling my angsty self. Just like, let me put some hair in my eyes and ooh, like I'm just, can you see the anger? This for me really brought that out. Excuse me, I'm heating my hair now. No, thank you. But like this palette, you guys, I almost bought it just for that reason. Like I almost bought the entire collab just for that reason because I love it. I love the packaging, the dark, like the feeling that it gives me inside my soul is so good. But in the end, just like with the ColourPop one, I decided not to get it because it's not something I would really use. And truthfully too, if I'm being honest, My Chemical Romance, yes, I love them, but I was also much more, I would say, into like the Fall Out Boy or Linkin Park. Like when I was getting angsty, or Metallica, Disturbed, like I was more in, those are several, I was gonna say that corner, but those are several different corners. But for me, My Chemical Romance was like a good band and I liked them, but they weren't like my go-to, you know, they weren't my Linkin Park or my Fall Out Boy or stuff like that. So I decided against it for multiple reasons, but like, bitch, when I tell you the nostalgia, ooh, it hit me right here. And by the way, just so you guys know, this officially means they're infiltrating us. Like they are officially getting us. They are getting our people, because if you're around my age, okay, I'm like 31-ish, and this collab is so spot on for like my age, for my generation, for my existence going through middle school into high school. This is the shit right here. So just so you guys know, they're getting us, okay? Like they're watching, they're learning, they're seeing our trends, they're seeing what we gravitate towards, and oh, they're doing a damn good job. All these companies are doing great. Ooh, you guys, let's just talk about, sorry, I get so excited. Bite Beauty has recently launched a mascara. They launched it on December 18th, and when I tell you, this is, oh my God, right up my alley. This is their new, what is this? Upswing Full Volume Mascara. mascara, and it says that it is powered by tree berry wax, which all of a sudden, I'm listening, okay? We love some good wax. And it says that it will grip every lash to give you buildable yet lightweight volume. It is volumizing, lengthening, lifting, curl enhancing, flake resistant, and smudge resistant. It is a full-bodied hourglass-shaped brush, solid black, $28, cruelty-free, vegan, and clean beauty. And let me just tell you, you guys, the shape of this wand, first of all, it is so satisfying on every level. Like, I love me a good, like, little curvy hourglass wand moment. I think that those are the best. They do a great job for me at really gripping and, like, lengthening my lashes and just pulling them up to Jesus. And I just freaking love mascaras like this, okay? Number one. Number two, I haven't tried a mascara from Bite Beauty in so long. So they had a mascara, didn't they? Moral of the story here, I will definitely be picking this up because I am so excited. I haven't grabbed it yet, but I will be. So look for this in a future video. I'm not sure when, or actually you'll probably see it on Instagram first, because I'm not gonna lie, I tend to do like little mini mascara reviews over there because I hate waiting because I love them so much. So definitely be on the lookout somewhere. Okay, so for those of you that don't know, I film these videos, and you can let me know down in the comments, by the way, if you want to see like more, less, if you like them, whatever. But I typically film these videos, these purchaser passes, every 2 weeks because I feel like that gives, you know, a little bit of time for new launches and whatnot. And so for me, like the first couple of items, like the things I've already talked about, they launched a couple of weeks ago. There's not as much hype surrounding them, like as far as my thoughts and opinions. But this product, okay, it just launched the other day, like in real time. This is the new Pro Filter Foundation Powder from Fenty. And when I tell you, I am so damn excited. I already ordered it. It launched on December 26th, so fairly recent. It comes in 50 shades, you guys. 50 damn shades. Did you hear? I want you to really lock eyes with me. 50 shades for a powder foundation? Like, okay, thank you, Fenty. Thank you, Fenty, for being absolutely damn fantastic and for just killing us all with this whole game. Retailing for $36, available on the Fenty website and Sephora, which, of course, I'll have everything linked down below. But you guys, just moral of the story here, I am so pumped to try this. I cannot wait. As soon as it gets here, I will be testing it. Again, it'll probably go up over on Instagram first because I'm not going to wait. Like, I can tell you right now, I am not going to wait until I have a video for this. I will be just, woo, I'll be powdering this puss with it as soon as I get it. I'll be powdering in this puss. Well, I'm glad I'm 75. So here's another one I am very interested in. I just saw it launch to Ulta like today or yesterday, but this is new from Benefit. This is their Porefessional Super Setter Setting Spray. And it says on here that it is a long-lasting, multitasking makeup setting spray that locks in makeup. It instantly blurs the look of pores, feels weightless, absorbs quick for a flawless look that won't smudge, transfer, or fade. It's supposed to have a microfine mist and really just make your skin look so damn flawless. And it says, it says on this post that the mini is 15, but it doesn't say, hold on, let me go over to Ulta. Do I have Ulta still pulled up? I feel like on my phone, Ulta is like always pulled up. All right, so I just found it on Ulta and it looks like the full size is $32. And do they even have the mini on Ulta? Oh, they do. Yep. And the mini is 15. So same pricing as listed on there, 32 for the full size, 15 for the mini, both available currently on Ulta, so I'll have those linked down below. I probably will test this out as well because I do love testing setting sprays, especially when they have, you know, like the micro mist and it's gonna be long lasting. Like I'm really into like checking them out, getting into the nitty gritty, seeing if they're worth the money. Also, we're just gonna jump right into the next one. No breathing, no nothing, because this, you guys, I am so excited. I'll be testing this one out for sure. It's new from Danessa Myricks and this is her new Balm Contour. And these, by the way, if you don't follow Danessa Myricks on Instagram, oh my God, what are you doing with your life? So good. Like the artistry, the way that everything is just sculpted and blended and so damn good and so sexy and so melted into the skin. I love it so much. Like watching this woman like do her craft, like do the damn thing. It is so impressive. I love it so much. The products look amazing. And this one specifically is just, it looks so good. They're described on here. It says this is an easy to use, weightless, super blendable and buildable balm to give your cheekbones a natural, effortless, yet impactful lifted and sculpted appearance. It is infused with hyaluronic acid, vitamin E, flower extract, and meadow foam seed oil to hydrate and nourish the skin for $26. And it comes in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. What is that? 8 shades, I think. Yeah, I think it comes in 8 shades. And they all look beautiful. I love the rain. range. Like Danessa Myricks, as far as the range and all of that, does a really, really great job. So definitely excited. I will be testing this out. All right, you guys, so here's one that I didn't expect to pick up, much less pick up the entire damn collection. But I was over on Ulta because, you know, Ulta, it's really Ulta's fault, okay? They never should have let me see the whole thing. But Buxom recently released an entire, like, White Russian line over there. There is an eye and cheek palette, which is $39. And that has 6 eyeshadow shades as well as 2 Wonderlust blushes. And again, retailing for $39. I freaking love it. I love the colors. I thought it looked beautiful. So I picked that up. I also picked up the Wanderlust Glow Highlighter, which is in, again, the shade White Russian, for $24. It is a primer-infused Ultra Luxe formula for a pearlescent luminous glow. There was also a Full Force Plumping Lipstick, again in White Russian, I know, big surprise. And this is a Lasting Creamy Pink Nude shade that plumps for an Ultra Lush Lip, $20. I think for me, it was just the entire look of it. Like, it had a good cohesion to it. And I'm not gonna lie, I was just, like, really in the mood for that, like, nice nudie pink vibe. Because sometimes I just go through that. Like, most of the time, I'm nudie brown. Like, I'm living this kind of, you know, brown beigey fantasy. But sometimes I just get that need, like, for the other side of the nude, like the pinky nudes. And this was just one of those moments for me. So, like I said, I picked up the collection. You'll probably see it at some point, video, Instagram, wherever. But I am super duper excited for this. I think it's gonna be beautiful. And I'm actually kind of excited too, because I haven't tested any of the Buxom eyeshadows in a while. So it'll be good to play with that formula. Also, really quick, I'm just gonna be fair here. I have given so much shade to Charlotte Tilbury for doing the pillow talk, like, over and over, which is ironic because I love the color story of it. Like, I've actually bought several pillow talk items, whether it's the lips, the glosses, the quads. I bought a lot of stuff that's the pillow talk line from them. But I feel like Buxom is kind of doing the same thing with their White Russian line. Like, they're kind of building on that thing, like, on the success of the first product. And I obviously don't know because I haven't tested these products, so I don't know if it's going to pan out or not. But I just, you know, I kind of wanted to point it out there. You know, what do you guys think? Because I have to be fair. Like, if I'm going to point it out for the one, obviously I have to point it out for the other. And it's not that I'm even against it. Like, I just, for some reason, I think with the Charlotte one, the reason that it bothered me so much is because for so long we were just like, product, product, product. And it's like they constantly were launching pillow talk, pillow talk, pillow talk. And you couldn't get away. It was like Beetlejuice, except all of a sudden we were just turning everything pink, poof. And I was getting kind of like an irritated vibe from that because it was happening so much. So my hope for the Buxom one is that they do it. It's well done. But, you know, they do it a couple of times and then maybe they just like pause for a second, like we slow down. And maybe we just kind of, we take a beat and, you know, we just kind of let that simmer. Otherwise I could see it getting like the same level of overwhelming, but, you know, just kind of my opinions. Want to hear from you guys, of course, in the comments, but either way, I'm excited to test it because I think it's going to be so pretty. And I really think I'm going to like it. Like, I've got good feelings. All right. So while we're talking nostalgia, please, can we just go there? This Peachy Queen palette that has the old style Nintendo clickers, you guys, the level of obsessed that I'm having is a whole thing, because this for me, like me growing up, okay, this was my Nintendo. This is what I was raised on for the first like 10 years of my life, was the old N64, like the little square remotes, the kind that when you held them for so damn long, your hand started to cramp in this position. It was long before, by the way, they thought about making like a good ergonomical control, like for the N64. Yeah, no, absolutely not, okay? I lived in the square time where it was like, how thick is this, okay? It was like, you know, roughly this long and you did this all day until your little hands, they thought they were actually gonna fall the fuck off, okay? That's how long you'd play this game. And these little square controllers, they hurt so bad, but they were absolutely amazing. And like seeing these controllers and seeing them turned into a palette, I just live and breathe for. So obviously I feel some kind of fantastic way about the packaging. Like right from the jump, I'm like, oh, they're doing it again. Like they're coming. I feel like they're looking right at me. Like they're just like, Paige, we're coming for you, for your age, for your people. And I'm here for that. Like again, packaging 10 out of 10, love it. But for me, I decided against it because again, it's not really my color story. Like I try to be that person that's like, Paige, think. Okay, you don't have to have it. Just because it's cute, you don't need to have it. And this was definitely one of those moments where I had to exercise restraint. But in the end, I just realized like this is not a color story that's really something I'm gonna reach for. It's not like it's really not cohesive for me personally in any kind of way. All right, so here's one that as of me filming this, it hasn't come out yet, but it should be available when this comes out. So I have it linked down below, as long as it's out. And this is a new collection from Natasha Denona. It's it's their I Need a Nude lip crayons. And you guys, what did I just get done saying about how much I freaking love all the nude colors? And Natasha Denona, they're coming out here with, what is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 different shades of all the beautiful nudes. Like, we've got some brown nudes, some pinky nudes, peachy nudes, like some that are kind of pinky purple. And I just think these are all so damn beautiful. They are, what do we have here? Comes in 8 shades, including 5 of the best-selling I Need a Nude lipstick shades and 3 nude shades with pink and beige undertones. Oh my God, yes, please, chef's kiss, mwah. I love you so much. You guys don't even know how much I love nude lip liners. It's like, it's a part of me. And these are gonna, what's the rest of the specs here? Delivers the intensity of a lipstick formula in a convenient pencil packaging for high precision. Love that. Soft, easy, slip-on glide application. Why was that so hard for me to read? Slip-on glide application with a matte finish to define the lips. Sharpenable plastic packaging like that of a wooden pencil. Lightweight and flexible, waterproof formula. Love that. That doesn't smudge or transfer. Vegan, cruelty-free. Love that. And that, $22 a piece. Don't necessarily love that. You know what? To be fair, these are Natasha Denona, so I'm not surprised that the price point's higher. And for it being like a higher-end brand, I mean, $22 for a lip pencil in general is expensive, but I'm not like super surprised because it's Natasha Denona. So in the interest of full transparency here, I'm just gonna let you guys know I will probably, like, and by probably I mean I will be picking up some of these because these colors, I just think they're so beautiful. All the nudie brown good things. I just think they're gonna be great. So I'm very excited about that. All right, so here's where we can end our list because this I am so excited about. Physicians Formula is launching, first of all, a matte butter bronzer for $13.99. And when I tell you, this is so exciting. I love a matte bronzer. Like, just my heart and soul is just content with it. I've given out so many chef kisses tonight, bitch. Like, they're just floating around this room. I'm just handing them out for free over here. But I love their formula. It's so nice, so smooth. And I'm really excited to see what the matte version is like. I think it's going to be amazing. There's also an all-star face palette, which this, oh my God, does this look beautiful. It has the matte bronzer I was talking about. It has the original butter bronzer. Their Mortal Glow Pearls powder, which is supposed to be like a beautiful glowy ass powder. Their multicolored powder, which again, beautiful powder. Rosé All Day Petal Glow, and their Happy Booster Glow and Mood Boosting Blush. And to get all of those in one palette for $17.99, just like, bitch, like bring it home to mama, because I am so excited. I think it's going to be beautiful. And I think the texture of it is going to be just so good. Like, to have all of these in one place, like knowing that you could mix if you wanted to, one day matte, one day the regular, you could mix the two together, just like have all the glowy good things. You can bronze, you can blush, you can highlight. I really feel like this is going to be great for me. The only thing I will say, hold on, I just realized I was looking up close at this display. I don't know if they came out with different shades of the matte bronzer, because when their original butter bronzers launched, they had like a really, really shitty shade range. It was one shade, and it didn't work. Well, then they went through and they extended the shade range. So with this one, I'm kind of confused because I can't really zoom in and see, like, are these all in the same damn shade? Did they launch them in different shades? It looks like, actually, hold on. It looks like I'm looking at the display, like I'm trying to zoom in, but it looks like there might be different shades of this available. So, and by the way, if you saw it in store, like I said, let me know down below what you have seen. But all right, you guys, with that, we are officially at the end of the video. That is everything I wanted to say. Make sure you leave me all of your thoughts on anything I talked about or other new launches down in the comments. And if I didn't say this already, everything that I am wearing to the best of my ability, I will have it linked down below. I don't know that I can link this. It's from American Eagle, but if I can, I'll link this. I will link, of course, all the makeup. Go watch the video that I already did putting all of this on. And of course, per usual, like I said at the start of the video, you can subscribe, turn on your post notifications, follow me on Instagram. All of that would be greatly appreciated, especially checking me out on Instagram if you haven't already. And you guys, I think that is everything. Thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.
Y'all, I just want you to know right now, I'm about ready to go fuck up some dinner. I don't even know what's out there. It just smells good. What does it smell like? I don't know. But I'm gonna go eat it. Like, I'm gonna just like put it all up in this face. Just like eat it. Like, just gonna get after it. I've been in here too long. But sometimes I get like that need, like the need for the pink goodness. And that sounded really bad. You can do it. Put your back into it. Uh-huh. You can do it. Put your ass into it. Uh-huh. You can do it. Put your back into it. Bringing on the back. Anybody else love Save the Last Dance, you guys? It's like one of my favorite movies of all time. And it just popped into my head. And all of a sudden, I'm like inundated with all of the songs that I love and like my youth. And then also coupled by the reality that I've carried with me for for 31 years that, my God, I cannot dance. I cannot. This is me. That's all I got. That's like, they're all like sexy and you can do it, put your back. And then this is me. Oh, Marzy Dotes and Dozy Dotes. Like, the Midwestern is strong in this room. It's really strong right here. Can you tell? It looked like I was bred in the cornfields. I look, especially with this hair, which I love the hair. No jokes on it. I think it's adorable. Especially this style. Like, this is very much so a style that works for, like, my face. But, like, I just, it just looks so Midwest. I look like I'm churning the butter, especially when I dance like this. Okay, so I'm done. Gotta go. Bye.